Good evening, my friends. I'm glad that you tuned in again to be with us on this day of the week, hallelujah, in which we come to share the word of our Father with you and to celebrate the one that has been so gracious to us to give us a gift. Always the gift is the Messiah. The gift is his word. The gift is to be able to hear the sound of his voice and to recognize that it is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God who created heaven, earth, the sea, and everything that is in it. The gift to be able to understand the instructions and the commands that he gives us, both from his commandments and daily commands that he instructs us to do. It's a gift to be able to inhale his spirit, because that's what it is. He breathed life into Adam, and Adam became a living soul. So we breathe in the breath of our Father, and we exhale. Hallelujah. And in doing that, we recognize that we are in the land of the living. And if something hurt us, or we thump our toes, or we have a toothache, we know we are still alive. So I'm glad to be able to greet you tonight with the mind of the Messiah. For those of you that may have tuned in for the first time, you will hear me say Yahushua. That's one of the Hebrew ways of saying Jesus' name. Also, Yeshua, Yahshua, but you'll hear me using Yahushua. For our Father, who you know as Lord God, some call him Adonai, some say Yahweh, some say Yahweh, Yahuwah, and there are many other ways that we call him. I use Yahuwah, bearing in mind that it is only one spirit of the living God of Israel that is orchestrating all of our lives. And that because of the blood of the Lamb, we have communication with each other. So I give honor unto the God of Israel. There's a scripture that Father gives me over and over again that is found in Isaiah 63rd chapter and the 16th verse. It says, "For you are our Father, though Abraham does not know us, and Israel does not recognize us. You, O Yahuwah, are our Father, our Redeemer. Your name is from of old." If you have the King James, I like, they do not acknowledge us, but I'm not going to get in depth tonight about who doesn't acknowledge us or recognize us. I just want to share that scripture with you so that you can be mindful that people may not acknowledge or recognize you for what you're doing, because you may not act like other people, and you may not talk like other people, and you may bring something that other people are not used to hearing. And so I want to encourage you. I want to say, be happy in your differences. Rejoice that our Father has given you a particular personality in which he can work through. And the scripture that also brings us together is when we say we have the mind of Yahushua. This King James would say the mind of Christ. Another scripture may say whatever. But if we have the mind of the Messiah, and if we have the whole armor of the God of Israel, are we not dressed in the same garments? Because to have the whole armor on of the God of Israel is to be wearing the light. His word is light and truth and water, living waters. To have the mind means that we have been studying Father's word, and therefore his thoughts that he put in us through his word become our thoughts, but his thoughts are different from ours. He can give you something that's not even in here. Hallelujah. There's nothing new under the sun that it is said. So why am I talking about the mind and the whole armor? And the fact that some of us are not acknowledged. No, that we're not acknowledged. I just want you to know that. There are people that will come, and you may have been ordained, and you may not have been ordained with papers, but you may have been called and you don't have any papers. Well, I sure wasn't going this route, but it's for somebody. Hallelujah. When you say you have the mind of the Messiah, and then you look in the Word, then you get to understand the doctrine that the Messiah brought here so that we can have a common way of, by the Spirit, to speak one to another. One is ordained with papers and the school credentials. Another may come out of nowhere with no credentials, and really nobody know who you are except by the Spirit of the living God of Israel. Now, I'm building up to, you know, I'm going to pray for headaches before this is over. That's why we're going to the head. That's the fact that you have the mind of the Messiah, the fact that we have been blessed so that we are covered, as we say, we are covered by the blood of the Lamb. We thank our Heavenly Father for how He has dressed us for this hour and for this time. Let's turn to 1 Corinthians, the second chapter. I'm just going to read some verses here in this chapter. Let's, Father, have me read all of it. But bear in mind, we're going to pray for headaches, because I've been encountering a number of people with different kinds of headaches. And there have been, some told me they have throbbing headaches, or some say they have a headache here, and some say their whole head hurt. And so, the Father wants you to be whole and well, so He don't want you to be packing around headaches that you don't need to carry, that since it is told us that Messiah died so that not only salvation could come to you, but so that you could have a healthy and a long life. Hallelujah. In 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, it says, "And brethren, when I came to you, did not come with excellence of speech or of wisdom, declaring to you the testimony of Yahuwah. For I determined not to know anything." 1 Corinthians. Okay. 1 Corinthians. All right. "Declaring to you the testimony of Elohim. For I determined not to know anything among you except Yahushua HaMashiach," or if you got King James, "Jesus Christ, and Him crucified." All right, look at that. Not to know anything among you except, okay, mind of Messiah. "I was with you in weakness and fear and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching were not with persuasive words of human wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith should not be in the wisdom of men, but in the power of Elohim," or the power of God. "However, we speak wisdom among those who are mature, yet not the wisdom of this age, nor of the rulers of this age who are coming to nothing. But we speak the wisdom of Yahuwah in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the ages for our glory." The mystery of why some people are not acknowledged, because we are hidden. The name Zephaniah means hidden. So some of us are still hidden, though we stand before you. But the Spirit of what Father is doing in us, that is not hidden. Hallelujah. And if we can't come in demonstration of the Spirit of Father's power and strength to bring healing to those that are sick in their heart, those with broken spirits, if we can't come, hallelujah, to help you to feel better, then it tells me that you don't really know the God of Israel, because we feel His Spirit in you when we come in contact with you. And in His Spirit, there is freedom and liberty. You can feel the difference. It's like coming into a place where there's a lot of the world called positive energy. Hallelujah. Something that makes was something that will help to lift you up out of whatever you may be in. You may be in a hopeless situation. But when one of God's children come among you, they will bring you hope through his spirit. Because if we have the mind of Yahushua, and if we are clothed in the armor of the God of Israel, and we have his word in us, we cannot help but make a difference, because the atmosphere just cannot remain the same when you come in contact with any of us that houses the Holy Spirit within us, because we bear about the marks of the Messiah. So here it says, which none of the rulers of this age knew, for had they known, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which Elohim has prepared for those who love him. But Yahuwah has revealed them to us through his Spirit. Hallelujah. For the Spirit searches all things. Yes, the deep things of Yahuwah, the deep things. The Spirit searches what's going on with your head when you get headaches and you don't understand why you have a migraine and it keeps coming. Hallelujah. And you get up and you take your aspirins and you say, I pray to God. I don't understand why I still have this constant headache. Something is going on. I think I might have a stroke. Wrong right there. Soon as you confess something like that, you, with the mind of Yahushua, you do not confess those kind of things. Hallelujah. But rather you confess that by his stripes, because Messiah died, I know that we can obtain our healing, because as they all say, we were healed. So if we were healed, we shouldn't be walking around here with sickness. But therefore, we don't understand everything that's going on. So since he say we were healed, if you keep confessing it, you're going to feel better. And your body eventually will follow the confession of your mouth. Hallelujah. It says, so, but Yahuwah has revealed them to us through his Spirit. Again, for the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of Yahuwah. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of Yahuwah. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit who is from Yahuwah, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by Yahuwah. Hallelujah. And if you are still with me, I am praying that the Spirit of our Father is speaking to you. Hallelujah. So that when I do pray for the headaches, you got anything else going on with you, you know, you have the ability to open your mouth and bring it to you because of the faith that Father has placed in all of us. These things we speak not in words which man's wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of Yahuwah, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he who is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is rightly judged by no one. For who has known the mind of Yahuwah that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of the Messiah. Hallelujah. And although some people do not recognize maybe the anointing on you, might not recognize it, but if they come to you and say, please pray, that's faith. Now, when I was, you know, I love to look up the different things with different sicknesses and things that's going on. And so I looked this piece of paper, about the headaches, and it describes migraine. It got migraine, the definition of a headache. It said a headache is a pain in the head. The headache can be caused by some other physical disorder, or it may be a disorder in itself. And it says there are three major types of headaches: tension or stress, migraine, and cluster. A tension headache is caused by the tightening of muscles in the neck and head. A migraine headache occurs when blood vessels in the brain dilate, swell up. Cluster headaches are characterized by very severe pain. Tension headaches are probably the most common form of disorder. nearly everyone has a tension headache from time to time. Tension headache, migraine, headaches are less common. And this is a little bit of history, because you have the mind of the Messiah, and we can do things different, though, you know, we are not acknowledged. Maybe they haven't acknowledged that you have the gift to heal, because you haven't acknowledged yourself. So the thing is, if we practice what Father put in our heart, guess what? Practice make what the world say perfect. Practice bring about things. When you practice something, you begin to believe it even more than when you first begin to practice it. All right. Migraine headaches are less common. It says about 18% of American women and 6% of American men experience migraine headaches on a relatively regular basis. That's interesting. We could stop there and talk, but we won't. Cluster headaches are fairly rare. Less than 0.5% of Americans experience cluster headaches. Men make up 80% of all cluster headache sufferers. Well, I didn't know that. I had read this, and I didn't stop at that. Let me just look right now, before we go any further, I'm going to pray with you that whoever tuned in, no matter what kind of headache you have, hallelujah, I'm going to pray that the Heavenly Father, because you have the mind of the Messiah, you have on the whole armor, you have the word in you, you believe, hallelujah, because you tune in there. You believe that we pray to our Father and that we do get a prayer through. That's why you're still looking. Hallelujah, because you have experienced something to understand about the workings of the Holy Spirit. And so you know what I do sometimes? I got my anointing oil on my hands, and James 5 say, call for the elders of the congregation or elders of the church if you are sick, and have them lay their hands on you, anoint you with oil, and pray for you. So, hallelujah, I'm going to pray for you and just pray that the Spirit of our Father will touch you even through the television. Heavenly Father, we thank you and bless you for your anointing that breaks every yoke. Heavenly Father, I pray in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, who is Jesus the Messiah, Father, that you would touch the cells that's in this area where the headaches are. I pray that you take away the discomfort of the headache, hallelujah, in whatever form it may be, whether it's the migraine, whether it's regular headaches or not. Father, I pray that you touch them, touch your head yourself. Father, we pray healing to manifest all the way through this entire part of the head and all the way through the body. I pray, Father, hallelujah, that you release the anointed to loose the tightness of these headaches and to touch them. Hallelujah, that you are still on the scene and you are still healing this day and this hour. Father, I pray, hallelujah, those that, hallelujah, that you have touched, hallelujah, that you would just continue, Father, to minister to every cell in that body that's connected to these headaches. And I pray, Father, those headaches are a signal for some other kind of disease in their bodies. I pray, Father, for you deliver them from any kind of infirmity in their bodies. Hallelujah, for your great name's sake. If there's a disorder of eating, hallelujah, that causes a situation in their brain, I pray, Father, that you would heal them of this disorder. Father, I pray for Father, thank you. If there's a disorder in your stomach in connection with your head in any form, I pray that Father that you would gallbladder, that you would send forth your word into the gallbladder and cause that the gallbladder to work the way it's supposed to. Hallelujah, the way you designed it to work. We call for a normal operation of the gallbladder, normal operation, hallelujah, of those that have these headaches, that they will no longer have these headaches, Father, for your great name's sake. We ask that you would bless them not to have them. Hallelujah. And those some of you that don't believe me, hallelujah, then you are stuck with your headache if that's what you want. But we pray that the Spirit of Father would divest you from it just because he's that good and is not waiting for you to understand. for his great name's sake. You know, all of this is to bring honor to the God of Israel, for your deliverance, for the healing of your body, for him to make a way for whatever it is that concerns you. Hallelujah. I don't think I need to go into the symptoms or anything like that. If there's anything else going on in your body, I ask that you touch your body. And you know, I'm always talking about drinking water, because apparently Father's always given me about the water and to pray over it. And so therefore, I'm praying that you would go and get water. Get yourself a glass of water. Hallelujah. And I pray that Father would just speak an anointing in that water. And when you drink it, then you will feel release. You'll feel release and relief. All right. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Father. There are some people out there that have been diagnosed. You can't go to the bathroom to do number two. Hallelujah. The word of our God is bigger than what goes on with your body. Hallelujah. And so I pray that the Heavenly Father would cause all your secretions in your body, the saliva, when you start your food process. I pray that the Father would send his word into from your mouth to your esophagus, down into your stomach, into your intestines. Hallelujah. Touching every part of it, that the Father's word itself will lubricate everything in your body. Hallelujah. And by faith, I pray that he would cause a normal opening and normal bowel movements for his great name's sake. For his name's sake, if you believe it. Father's the best unblocker that I know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is interesting. Well, all right. Father, we give you praise and honor. We're back. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We bless you. We bless you for your word. We bless you for your word. Hallelujah. We bless you for your word. Is there anything else? Father, we thank and bless and praise you again, Father, for, hallelujah, for those that have situations with their kidneys. Father, we ask that you would touch them and regulate the kidneys, and whatever they've been diagnosed with, we ask that you would heal them of the situation they have with their kidneys, and that when they go back to the doctor will be surprised, Father, when they go back and try to check them out, and they'll see that what they thought was there is no longer there, for your great name's sake. And also, you that are tuned and having to do with your kidney, the Father, I'm trying to wait for him to give me a scripture to give you, because he wants you to read in the Psalms 103, and you with the kidney situation, and read it for 7 days. You know, the doctor sometimes give you medicine, and he'll tell you to take it for 7 days, and then you don't have to take it anymore. The Father wants you to do this for 7 days. How many times a day? Well, I'm getting do it once a day, but the Spirit will come to you and tell you something else, because the more you read it during each one of those days, the quicker you will have you will feel the difference in your kidney functioning. I'm telling you, I know I'm hearing Father. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Well, anyway, having the mind of Yahushua and remember that when he sent out his disciples, he sent them all out with the ability to be able to bring healing to Father's people and to bring deliverance. And you are not here where Messiah was, but you are here now by faith. And just as the disciples receive a Messiah, you're receiving everything. You're receiving the baptism of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit. I mean, there is nothing impossible for the Father to be able to do through you. Hallelujah. Well, having that mind and knowing that you have been chosen to be different among Father's people. Do be different. You don't have to be like everybody else. You don't have to talk like everybody else. Just do as the Father leads you to do, even though it doesn't make any sense. Even though someone may say, you don't really know what you're doing. You don't keep things going in order. See, the Holy Spirit keeps things in order. And if he's still desiring for us to be whole and well. And so, Father, we just thank our Father for blessing us today. We thank him for blessing you tonight. May he seal up in you what he's put in there. May he increase the faith in you to believe. And when you lay hands on yourself, believe this. And if you got some oil in your house, anoint your wherever you hurt. Just anoint it and believe that the God of Israel is still working a work in this hour for his great name's sake. Hallelujah. Well, anyway, we're over with this program just about. Remember to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Remember, hallelujah, we are to love one another. And if you're different, rejoice in that difference. Be the different one that Father can use in this hour to bring healing and deliverance to his people. But above and beyond that, to bring the Messiah. Do you know the Messiah? Lift your hands up and ask him to come into your heart and change your life. Let him come in so that you can have the mind of the Messiah. We bless our God of Israel. Because there is none like him, let me tell you. Hallelujah. So lift your hands and praise the God of Israel for his mighty work, for the love that he has placed in our heart for each other, for his Ruach HaKodesh, his Holy Spirit, and for his nation of people. Shalom upon you. Peace and blessings upon you. Health, strength. Spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet, and tell my people their transgressions, and the house of Jacob their sins. Blow ye the trumpets in Zion, sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of Yahweh is at hand. Your mouth is a trumpet. Blow ye the shofar. Amen.
A love song from the birds to tell you that you're marvelous to marvel. Thank you.